Hello there, you can see here I am controlling the LED of ESP8266 through the web browser and also through the mobile app. Also you can see the temperature reading on both devices. I am controlling this with the Arduino IoT Cloud. So in this video tutorial, let's see how to use Arduino IoT Cloud platform and also see how to read temperature and how to control LED using Arduino IoT Cloud. So let's get started this video. First, let's grab the components. We need a breadboard, a Node MCU, an LM35 analog temperature sensor. First, I placed the Node MCU on the breadboard. Then I connected the positive of the sensor to Node MCU VIN pin. Then I connected the negative to ground. Finally, I connected the output to pin A0. Then connect USB cable to ESP8266 and the computer. Now go to your browser and search for Arduino IoT Cloud and select IoT Cloud from the top right corner. Here first you have to sign up with your account, then click on create thing, then click on add variable. Here we need two variables for doing this project. Let's start with the LED, then select the variable type. I selected as boolean because we need to pull high or low. Finally click to add a variable, that's it. Now the same way add temperature variable. Here you have to choose the temperature sensor as variable type. After that, let's configure the device. For that, click on the link icon and select setup third party device and search and select the Node MCU. Now click continue, then change the device name and click on next. That will give you a secret code. You can also download that from this tab. Now copy that secret key, then click continue. Now we need to set up the network. Just give the SSID and password of your network. Also paste the secret code that we copied earlier. Now click on save. Now let's set up our dashboard. For that, click on dashboard. From the coming window, select the pencil tool to add widget. Click on add. Then first choose a switch to control the LED. Now we need to select the variable that is associated with the LED. So I chose LED, then click link variable. Next, to display the temperature, I chose a gauge widget, same as before. Here we need to select the temperature sensor as variable. Finally, I added one more widget called chart and I linked that with the temperature variable. Now go back to things, click on our thing and select the sketch tab and click on the open full editor. Now you can see the basic code of this project. Everything about the IoT side is already included in the code. We just need to write couple of lines. So first I declared the sensor pin. Then in the loop section, first I read the analog value of the sensor and converted it into Celsius. Finally I linked that value with the temperature variable. Also I write conditions for the LED change, and that's all about the program. Now let's compile the code. Select board and compile. Now you can see back-to-back errors, which comes because we need to download and install Arduino agent to upload code from online. So I downloaded and installed the Arduino agent. Now you can see the Arduino agent. Also see the message of board connected. Compiling is now happening and it's done. Now let's upload code to ESP. After few seconds you can see the code is uploaded. Now let's test the circuit. Go to the dashboard and click on your project. Now you can see the temperature readings on display, and you can see when I click switch, LED is turning off and on. Now let's bring soldering iron near to the sensor, and you can see the temperature is increasing, so everything is working perfectly. Now install Arduino IoT remote app on your smartphone and open it. You can see the same as in the web page. We can control and read data also from the mobile device. The best part is when I change the switch on phone, the web page will automatically updated and vice versa. So using the Arduino IoT cloud platform is much easier than other services, and I feel more delay to upload code online, but we can solve that by avoiding online coding. So that's all about Arduino IoT cloud. Hope you enjoyed and learned something about Arduino IoT cloud. If so, please like, share and subscribe. All up to you. I will see you next time.